الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، from the benefits of Tawheed and the importance of Tawheed, the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and that our da'wah, the da'wah of Ahl Sunnah, is simply, as Imam Muqbil bin Hadi al-Wadi'i, Allah yarhamuhu, he mentioned, da'wah to Ahl Sunnah, da'watun min kitabillah ila kitabillah, wa min sunnati rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, ila sunnati rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. He said, the da'wah of Ahl Sunnah, it's the call from the Book of Allah, to the Book of Allah, and from the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, to the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And from the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fi kitab al-kareem, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسَ لِيَعْبُدُونَ, I have not created mankind and the jinn except for the purpose of worshipping me. وَقَوْلُهُ وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ نَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fi kitab al-kareem, and we sent to every nation a messenger to ordered with worshipping Allah alone and being away from Tawgut, being away from those things which are falsely worshipped. That is what all the prophets alayhim afdhal salatu wasalam were called to. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fi kitabi al-kareem, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fi kitabi al-kareem, and your Lord has commanded you to not worship anyone except Him, إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, and to the parents be obedient or be righteous or give ma'ruf. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fi kitab al-kareem, وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also commands us, He tabarak wa ta'ala says, وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ, and worship Allah, وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا, and do not associate any partners with Him. So it shows us, ahabati fillah, the ahimiyat to tawheed, the importance of tawheed, the importance of calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what we're ordered to do. So I'm reminding myself, first and foremost, as I speak, I feel the urgency. So this is a reminder to myself and a reminder to my brothers and sisters, the importance of calling to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, calling to Tawheed, actualizing Tawheed, practicing Tawheed, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Here's what Imam bin Baz rahimahullah ta'ala says. And so we're just going to bring a few fawaid from this great Imam of the Sunnah, Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, and what he said, just briefly about these verses. He said, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned, after mentioning about the aqsam at-tawheed, the categories of tawheed, he said, wa hadhihi aqsam at-tawheed ath-thalatha wa anwa'iha wa anwa'ihu tawheed fi rububiyyah wa tawheed fi al-asma'i wa sifat وتوحيد في إلهية وهذا معلوم باستقراء من كتاب الله وسنة رسوله عليه الصلاة والسلام فهو واحد في إيجاد الخلائق الخالق لكل شيء عز وجل ليس له شريك في خلق عباده وتدبير أمورهم وهو واحد في أسمائه وصفاته لا شبيه له ولا كف له ولا ند له ولا يقاس بخلقه سبحانه وتعالى وهو واحد في استحق العبادة لا يستحقها سواه. So the Imam, he mentions, he said that this is the three types of Tawheed. And he mentions, he says, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, the Lordship of Allah, wa Tawheed fi asma'i wa sifat, and Tawheed of the divine names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa Tawheed fi ilahiyya, and Tawheed in the, that all worship belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, wa hadha ma'lum bi istiqra. He said, and this is known by deduction, meaning deducing from the nasus, from the text, from the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. Meaning that from the Quran and the Sunnah, it gives us the evidence. So it shows us also the minhaj of Ahl Sunnah, how that differs from the people of desires. That Ahl Sunnah, they bring these qawaid and these principles and these usul from the Quran and the Sunnah. They don't go to the Quran and the Sunnah and they don't make up their usul and their methodology and their madhab and their understandings of the religion and their principles and then run to the Quran and the Sunnah to try to back it up. But Ahl Sunnah, they take it, they deduce it from the text. They deduce it from the Quran, from the Book of Allah and the Sunnah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And then he says that Allah, He is Al-Wahid. He is the only one in creating the creation. He's the only creator of the creation. وَهُوَ خَالِقْ لِكُلِ شَيْءٍ He created everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there, He has no partners in sharing in the creation of His servants and planning their affairs. And He is one and unique in His divine names and attributes. And there is nothing that resembles Him. And He has no partners and no associates. And there is no analogies regarding, there's nothing analogous with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His between Him and His creation. And He is one in His right for deserving to be worshipped alone. And there is no one worthy of worship except Him. So those are just some of the fawaid that Imam bin Baz mentioned, and he mentioned so many in his book, Kitab al-Tawheed. And I just want to end with this last ibara. He said, after all of those ayats, he said, "Fi ayat kathirat kullaha tadullu ala annahu mustahik al-mustahik lil-ibadah." He said, there are so many verses in the Quran which illustrate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.